Hello guys and welcome back. So in the last lecture we created our enemy. Now we want to create some damage system for enemy. Now if we click on play, you can see our enemy is following our player. So now let's create one more enemy. So right click and duplicate our police car and let's move it to the right side. And if we play now, you can see both of them are colliding and following our player. Now what we want to do is, when our enemy cars collide with each other, we want them to take some damage. Now so let's create a damage script. So in the scripts folder, create a new C# script and rename it to damage. Let's delete this one, we will edit only one. So let's drag our damage script on it. And now double click on damage script to open it in Visual Studio. Create a new private variable int life, and it will be 3 by default, and this will decide how many times enemy car can get hit. Then we create a private int current life, and this will check how many remaining hits enemy can take. And we make life a serialized field so we can edit it from inspector. Now in the start we set current life is equal to life, as we want to have full life at start. Next we want them to reduce life when they collide with each other, so we call OnCollisionEnter method. OnCollisionEnter method is unity method, and it is called when two objects collide with each other. So in it we check if, let's change collision to other, and now we say if other.collider.compare tag is enemy. So here we are checking if we are colliding with enemy tag game object, then we reduce our life. So current life is reduced by 1. And if current life is less than 0, then we debug a log message enemy destroyed, and then we deactivate the game object. So we type game object dot set active false. Okay, so now if we go back and if we play, so let's click on apply here, so this become part of the prefab. Right click and duplicate, let's move it to the right side. And now if we play, you can see our enemies are colliding but they are not deactivated. So if I pause it, you can see here, let's select this and go to debug mode. You can see our current life is reduced, but is reduced by only 1. So what's happening is, OnCollisionEnter method is only called when two objects collide with each other, and it is called only once. So even after the two objects are colliding or continue to collide with each other, this method is not called. It is called only once. So we are reducing our life only once. So instead of using OnCollisionEnter, let's use OnCollisionStay method. And OnCollisionStay method is called when two objects are colliding and they are continuously colliding with each other. So if we go now, let's play. You can see our enemy cars got deactivated, but they got deactivated instantly when they collided, and we don't want that to happen. So we will create some invincible time. So we create a float invincible time, and it will be 2 by default. And this is the time between which enemy car won't get any damage. We create another float current invincible time, and this will track the remaining invincible time. So cut the below code and create a new method, public void reduce life, and then paste the code in it. Next, we create a new private bool is colliding, and it will be false by default. Is colliding will be set to true when enemy car is colliding with another enemy car. So here in OnCollisionStay we type is colliding equal to true. And we have one more method, which is OnCollisionExit, and this method is called when two colliding objects are no more colliding with each other, and it is called only once. So we'll copy this and paste it here, and we will set it to false. And here we will copy and paste it here. Okay, so now here in update we'll say if is colliding is equal to true, that means our enemy car is colliding with another enemy car, then we reduce current invincible time by time dot delta time, and if our current invincible time is less than zero, then we reduce our life. And in reduce life method, once we have reduced our life, we reset current invincible time to invincible time. So if we save it and go back, so if we press on play, you can see our enemies are colliding, but they are not destroyed as soon as they collide, and they get destroyed after some time. So now our invincible time is working. So let's create some effects. So let's create a private game object variable, and we will have some smoke effect, some fire effect, and some explosion effect, and we will serialize it so we can see it in inspector. And here in reduce life we will say if our current life is equal to 2, then we will activate our smoke effect. So smoke effect dot set active to true, else if our current life is equal to 1, then we will deactivate our smoke effect and activate our fire effect. So fire effect dot set active to true, and here we will say else if our current life is less than 0, then we will debug a message, and we will create a explosion effect. So instantiate explosion effect at transform dot position, and we want its rotation to be idle or its default rotation. So if we go back, let's delete this clone. So now select this, and we will create a new game object, and let's go back to our normal mode and rename it to FX, and we will store our effects here. So go to our prefabs folder, and let's drag our fire effect here, and let's double click to zoom, and let's put it here. Deactivate our smoke effect as a child of FX. Let's drag it here and deactivate. And if we select our police car, we have these fields. So just drag our fire effect in our fire effect, smoke effect to smoke effect, and drag this explosion to our hierarchy. And we don't want any rubble effect, so we can just select this one and select this gear icon and click on remove component, and let's rename it to explosion. Select prefab folder and drag it to it to create a prefab. Just delete this, and now select our police car and drag your explosion to explosion effect field. Now right click, duplicate, and let's move it to the right side. Now if I play now, you will see some smoke effect is taking place, now fire effect is also taking place, and explosion is taking place. So let's have some changes to our effects here. So let's see what we can change. So let's change our duration to 0.5, and for smoke also let's say 0.5. Let's try now. So select this police car, click on apply, and let's try it. Okay, now you can see. So the values which I found which are good for this are duration to be 1, start life to be 0.5, our starting size to be 1.5, and same for our smoke. So 1, 0.5 and 1.5. if you click on play, so select and click on apply, and now play it, and you can see the smoke effects are taking nicely. So guys, we have created our damage system for our enemy cars. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture.